to the
I try to save the situation, then I end up misbehaving. Hey now, say now, about to break down. Yeah, come on and ride with Ray now. In the picture, she looks great now. And everything's gonna change now.
All right, here we go.
Yeah, it has been a week, one of those weeks, one of those days, like, that's why I'm once again on camera looking crazy, but I mean, we're like BFFLs, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah. In today's video, I wanted to share with you guys some characters that, like, I have added to my personal doll collection universe or whatever. I have, notes in my email drive of, some of my new name characters or characters that I put together, as couples, siblings, cousins, whatever the case may be. So I thought that this would be kind of fun to share with you guys, and then towards, the end of the video, I will also share how to dye your Rainbow High doll's hair, because I got a comment from the Prestigious Brat. Y'all check out her YouTube channel, period. And she was asking, you know, like, if I could do a video in regards to that. And because it is such a simple thing, I'm gonna throw that in here towards the end and do just talk about how to pretty much do that. Very easy, very simple, because me, like, child, I need for things to be simple for me, okay, period. So let's go on ahead and get started. Okay, y'all, so I'm gonna try to bring some of these girls up close, but we'll also be taking a shift over to the Rainbow High house, because that's where some of the girls are. But the first girl, this is a Robin Sterling doll, which I know y'all saw her, or if you didn't, she was in my last previous video, I want to say, as like a haul doll slash like kind of like doll restyle, because this is my second one. But her name is Tiffany Huxtable, so introducing the queen, Tiffany Huxtable, and her focus is jewelry design. This is Tiffany Huxtable now, and her focus is jewelry design because she is super into jewelry, such as Daphne is an accessory design focus. So they take similar classes together. Diamond industry, like diamond jewelers and things like that. That is Miss Tiffany Huxtable. And of course she comes from a very wealthy family. Top of the top jewelry, diamonds, they got it all. They get like some of the finest diamonds and jewels from across Africa and other foreign countries. She lives and breathes jewelry and everything pretty much that's luxurious in that aspect. So yeah, once again guys, this is Tiffany Huxtable and she is a jewelry focus. Next, you guys, I'm going to introduce y'all to Daria's sisters. So this is Daria's oldest sister and her name is Bianca, and she is the oldest of the three. So Daria is the middle child and then their youngest sister is Maya. So yeah, this is Bianca, and she does not really have any background as far as like her being in Rainbow High. If anything, I was thinking of just making her alumni, but she comes to visit, you know, Daria a lot at school and things like that. So yeah, so here she is, and she is actually the best friend to my double of my double Daphne doll, but I haven't made up a name and stuff just yet for her. But yeah, so this is Bianca Roslin, also known as Daria's oldest sister.
Now we're moving into the house. So this is Daria's youngest sister, Maya Roslin, and she will be a soon-to-be first year at Rainbow High. So yeah, she doesn't have a focused background just yet, but yeah, she's the youngest sister to Daria and Bianca in the back. But yeah, so here she is. She's actually sitting here talking to my other girl, who is... This is my variant Cheryl, quote-unquote, custom. I dyed her hair brown, as you guys can see, and I did cut it. This is Bridget Winchester. Her focus is event coordination. So she's really all about helping, like, map out and put together, like, fashion shows or promotional events, pop-up shops, whatever the case may be. Anything that is fashion related that promotes any type of event, whether huge brand name or small brand names, that's what her focus is in, is event coordination. Yeah, this is Bridget Winchester. I know y'all can see this is Miss Sunny in the back, who just woke up trying to make herself something to eat. And then this is Poppy, both still canon characters. However, Miss Sunny has a sister actually that is not too much far in age from her. This is Sunny's sister, who is older than her by a year, and her name is Breezy Madison. I do not have any background yet, by, you know, considering her as like a senior at Rainbow High or anything. But yeah, but this is Sunny's older sister, only by a year. Her name is Breezy Madison, and they basically have the same exact personality, except for Breezy is kind of a more introverted version of Sunny, yet they do both have the same personality. So yeah, and obviously this is the winter break Sunny doll, who I've chosen to make as her older sister. So yeah, that is Miss Breezy Madison. And moving down, you guys, as you can see, this is a Vanessa Tempo duplicate from the Rock line. And her name is Viana Nicole. She's the twin sister to Vanessa Marie, my original Vanessa. She's up here on the deck. Here she is in the living room holding some stuff. I guess she's about to do some homework or whatnot. As Viana's focus is actually interior design at Rainbow High. So she's really into the creativity and aesthetic of a specific space that somebody happens to reside or live in. So she is the person to go to when the girls like want something redone to their dorm room space, or want something added or rearranged to the actual house, the classrooms, all that, whatever the case may be. She is your girl. And yeah, her focus is interior design, and she is amazing at it. This is Hayami Chen, and she is my Emmy duplicate custom, quote unquote. I dyed the ends of her hair black, but she actually will be getting a haircut, which is really exciting. She actually has like a birthmark on her eyebrow, so it makes her eyebrow darker than the other. It's kind of a little uniqueness about her. She's over here at the table stitching, working up on some designs and stuff like that. Her focus is fashion marketing. So yeah, so she's into pretty much everything that has to do with getting, you know, people to see your creative visions. You know, she works a lot with anybody at Rainbow High who has like a boutique business, like an online business. And you know, she also partners up sometimes with Bridget for like event planning, because since she is into fashion marketing, she does that part of marketing the product, which is usually something that is fashion related. So yeah, once again, this is Hayami Chen, and her focus is fashion marketing. And I'm really excited to cut her hair shorter real soon.
So yeah, you guys, so that pretty much wraps up some of my newly introduced Rainbow High characters. Like I said, some of them are still in the works as far as like what name I want to go with for them and their background focus, who I want them related to, whatever. Obviously, not all of them are going to be connected to our canon Rainbow High characters. Some of them are literally just their own personal student, such as Bridget Winchester, for example. So, yeah. As far as Bratz, you know, of course, Sasha and Cruz are definitely a canon relationship in my collection. And the doll that I use for that is the Wildlife Safari Dylan, because he looks the most like Cruz from the movie / TV web series where they all go to Paris on like this like spy trip. Though at the end of that specific episode, we don't really know like where they took a turn to, because all it ended on was like him apologizing to her and clearing up the rumors about him and Alonce. And though she accepted the apology, there was pretty much nothing else said after that. But in my universe, they are still definitely a couple, or, you know, she's on that, that's my man and I'm gonna stick beside him. He's my man when he's not my man, when he's my man, when he's my man. Bryce from the Genie Magic movie was when we were first introduced to him. He actually has a crush on Felicia in my collection. Like, I don't know. I just really feel like...
You done lost your damn mind.
He is so infatuated with Felicia and would really love for her to give him a chance. Obviously, in the Genie Magic movie... people would say that him and Katya are a thing. But in my personal opinion, I feel like Katya was really into Bryce. And her crush was with Bryce, not really Bryce's crush was with her. But of course, you know, I'm sure he's like, you know, we can be cool, whatever. Like, you know, he was very sweet to her, whatnot. But the vibe was giving very much, she's more into you than you're into her. So, yeah, but I don't know. I feel like he has, like, a crush on Felicia, at least in my universe. So, yeah. Will she ever give him a chance? Who really knows? But, yeah. So, a canon couple. Please, y'all, do not hurt me. This was before Roxy and Nevra were, like, the confirmed couple in the Bratz universe. You know, I don't know who all confirms that or not, but, hey, you know what I'm saying? I'm all for it, period. But beforehand, actually, in my personal Bratz universe, Nevra was always paired with Kobe. Like, I just feel like from their personalities, as far as description-wise, and even how Kobe is in the Bratz Darn and Silent movie, I don't know. They both give me very much, like, reserved vibes. Like, every time I look at Funk Out Nevra, and any of Kobe's first couple of dolls, like, that's just what it gives. So, I feel like they're, like, a shy, kind of reserved couple, very respectful of each other's boundaries, values, whatever they got. So, yeah, I actually have them as a couple in my, Bratz universe. That is not to say Never and Roxy can't be together, because they damn sure can be. But just in my universe, I always saw, like, Kobe and Never. Yeah, Liz, I can see. Okay, so Megan gives me very much, she likes girls energy.
Did I lie? Did I lie? Did I fucking lie?
Like, yeah, so Megan prefers, she has no preference as to dating guys or girls. Which I guess would make her bi, but, like, you know, she doesn't like to put any label on herself. She's very, like, you know, she likes what she likes. But she prefers, though, to date women, actually. So that's something I came up with. I don't know. Let me know in the comments if y'all can kind of see the vibe or whatnot. If y'all feel me, if y'all don't feel me, whatever, okay? I'm still working on that because I would like to do more pairing as far as, like, other Bratz characters and stuff like that. Dylan will never be paired with anybody because he's too much of a player in general, and in my universe, he is still a player, so he ain't gonna be tied down no time soon, child. Scooting back to Kobe, one of my grail dolls that I got a long time ago, with Secret Dates Kobe. I think he's the one of the cutest Bratz boys ever. And he shares like a similar screening to, I think, Wildlife Safari Kobe, also with like the buzz cut. Shout out to Edigs, because me and my bestie Edigs, we basically have it canon that that specific Kobe, like Secret Dates Kobe, is the brother to the twin set Peyton and Nevaeh. If you look at those three dolls side by side, you would see the sibling resemblance, period. So with that being said, Kobe is the brother to his twin sisters, Peyton and Nevaeh, and they are from the Bratz World Families collection, if you don't know. But yeah, so that, yeah, them three, He's not a triplet at all, he's just their brother. So yeah, Peyton and Nevaeh and Kobe are siblings, period. Now, these two are technically canon. I just have to pretty much create or add whatever doll I feel like will closely match them, in my opinion. So, Sasha has a little sister named Zama, spelled Z-A-M-A. There is or was a two-pack release of Bratz Kid Sasha and a Bratz Baby Sasha. So, when I came across that pic, because I've never seen that set in my real life, I was like, oh, okay, like, at some point I'm gonna just buy a Bratz Baby Sasha and pair her closest to another Sasha in my collection, and officially make my own Zama. Which, the Bratz Baby's Sasha doll that's in that two-pack, and y'all will see a picture as well, is, I think, Hair Flare Sasha. So, yeah, that's definitely gonna be continuously canon in my collection. Sasha having a little sister named Zama. Also, going back to Miss Megan, I don't know if y'all know, but Megan does have an older sister named Tanya. She was introduced in the Bratz Kid Sleepover Adventure movie when she told her scary story. And in my opinion, her sister looks the closest to the B-Bratz brunette doll by looks, just if that doll had shorter hair, in my opinion. So yeah, I don't really know how I would pull that off, because there's clearly a huge age gap between that Megan and her older sister, as you can see from the movie. However, could it still be achieved? Of course. But yeah, so that's still canon, whether I have a doll that matches up with Tanya or not in my collection, is if somebody were to ask Megan, hey, do you have siblings? She'd be like, oh yeah, I have an older sister named Tanya. And I also feel like Harvey is low-key her little brother. Now, if not little brother, maybe cousin, because Harvey would be the same age as the Bratz characters according to the Bratz Babies movie. So I feel like Harvey has some relation to Megan. Maybe cousin instead of little brother. What do y'all think? I think yes, period. So yeah. Now I'm going to get ready to explain to you guys how to dye your Rainbow High Dolls hair. How to dye your Rainbow High Dolls hair. Okay, y'all. So I am going to make sure to include like photos and whatever footage I may have as I'm explaining this. So for one, I didn't start trying to, you know, do dye jobs on my doll's hair until I experimented on it with Rainbow High Dolls. And I pretty much really did it to the fullest to my Mini-Me doll. Shout out to Jade's Leo on Dollstagram, because I messaged them asking about the dye jobs they've done on their Rainbow High Dolls, which look absolutely amazing, like skin dye jobs and even hair dye jobs. So I did it to my mini me, who actually is like right there in the house. So yeah, and then I have since then done it to other dolls, such as I have a Karma doll that I've done it to and all that other stuff, which I will make sure to get show y'all close-ups as I am talking. So the dye that I use every time to dye my Rainbow High doll's hair is the brand Rit dye. You can find this at Hobby Lobby, you can find it at Walmart, you can find it at Target. However, Hobby Lobby and Walmart usually have more colors to choose from. Target be kind of dry. So yeah, this is it. So this is just one that's a wine color. Obviously you can get any colors. I would suggest doing this in your kitchen using a stainless steel pot, because this dye, it's dye, so you know it's gonna die. But yeah, so get a stainless steel pot, of course. Fill it up with water and boil it until it's like super hot. Then once you add a good amount of this dye, I just kind of pour into my leisure, but I probably pour in at least 2 to 3 capfuls of the dye. And then I will add in a couple of drops of dish soap. Now I think on the instructions, dish soap is something to add to the dye, but like I said, I've done this myself just based off of tutorials and stuff like that. But I'll add a few drops of dish soap and then I will mix up the dye. And then after it is boiling hot, I will turn it off, because by then the water is already super hot. And what I will do is I will dip my doll's head all the way in, being extremely careful to not really get any on their like forehead or anything. If you do, it's not a big deal. All you gotta do, like, have a rag nearby and just like wipe it off, because yeah. Now, could you possibly risk staining the doll? You could, if you aren't being super careful. My dolls do not have any stains, and if I was like dumping their head in to get as close to the root as possible, because that's the goal, and they got a little dye on them, I would just wipe it off and it was like no problem. And then once your doll's hair or head is whatever is submerged into the dye, I pretty much do a method where I constantly will just dip the hair in and out, in and out. I will let the doll sit for about not too long, like maybe like 10-15 minutes, and then afterwards I will of course get them out of the dye, and then I will let them sit and lay on a towel for like another like 15-20 minutes. Then I proceed to rinse their hair under cold water to get any excess dye out. But usually what should happen is the hair should catch all of the dye. You know, you dry the hair, get ready to style. So yeah, that's pretty much how you would dye your Rainbow High doll's hair. For my girl Bridget specifically, what I did was I mixed this wine dye and I mixed a dark brown dye together to give the dark brown a lighter brown kind of tint to it, if that makes sense. Shout out to Seashell Collection Sis for the pointers on that. Yeah, so there are times where you might have to mix the dyes together in order to achieve a specific hair color for your doll. So yeah, this way is very simple and easy to do, especially if you're not the best at rerooting or if you want to just save time and avoid rerooting. This method is the best, specifically for Rainbow High dolls. I have yet to have tested this out on like OMG dolls or Bratz dolls. Apparently you can dye Bratz doll hair with red dye, I guess depending on the doll's hair type or whatever. But I've only done this on Rainbow High dolls. So if you choose to do this on another doll, you're doing it at your own risk. You've been warned, period. That's pretty much it for today's video. It was kind of a random video, but I've been trying to uplift my spirits lately, and there's no other way I feel like I can do that if I don't film a doll-related video for you lovely people to look at, just because this week your girl is like stressed and stuff with you know, just trying to get new opportunities and stuff like that. And yeah, you know, just, you know, manifest for your girl. It would be much appreciated. But anyways, you guys, I hope y'all enjoyed this video, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye, booze.